Man, last night it was Friday Night Lights, folks. You should have seen all across the flatlands of West Texas, high school football, the playoffs. They lit up the skies down here in Texas. And man, what great high school football they play down here. There's that flanker screen for the Red Raiders. And Wilker, 8 or 9 yards on that play before Allen makes a tough stop, number 48. Good-looking range for that linebacker right there. Now, Gary mentioned it. So quickly, Dr. Graphics gets it ready. Now look at this. This is what they're averaging. Gary, look at that.
Wow, look at these. They haven't given up a touchdown in the last three games right there. And, you know, they have played against. There's a lot of offense in this conference. Maybe not a lot of defense against these guys. Oklahoma, far and away the class of this conference. Put up 65 on Texas, didn't they?
Yes, they did.
Easy, easy.
First down with Henderson, the ball carrier that time. And Allen again making a stop. And, the Pacific Life game summary focuses in on this Oklahoma defense. Well, great coverage.
You better do things right when you're going against this defense because they are fast, they react to the ball, and they have playmakers on defense. We haven't even seen a lot of their defensive line because this style offense throws it so quick, you really don't get to call those guys' names out a lot.
Yeah, in fact, he hasn't been sacked yet, and he escaped punishment that time. Gimpy knee and all, slides for the first down. B.J. Simmons puts a charge in the offense that time. 13 yards, and he must have been a pretty good runner before that injury.
Yeah, we're seeing about 50%. Here's the blitz that's been used all day. They run the zone blitz. They go three deep behind it. This time they whiff on him. Five guys blitz. They drop to Cody, the defensive end of the flat, and that's why you get all that space up there. And B.J. is doing it maybe 70% with that knee. He's starting to find his fastball, though, hitting the guys in the numbers. They got to start catching.
Yeah, just a question of hanging on here. There they did, going down to a knee. As Glover makes the catch just short of midfield at about the 48-yard line. And Leach has to be a little bit pleased with this drive so far, Jack.
Well, Brent, absolutely. And you know, when they say that B.J. Simmons is a product of Mike Leach's system, don't tell Bob Stoops that, because Bob Stoops says, this is a kid that's a true athlete. In fact, he said, hey, guys, if it was a product of the system, all Mike Leach would have to do, go to the local convenience store and go to the Slurpee counter and find the next quarterback for Texas Tech.
When do you see Texas Tech in the second quarter with more rushing yards than passing yards? And showing the end of round, but there is a whistle. Walker was going to that far side. And so alertness by Miss Sun Devil down there, who noticed that on the statistics with 9:59 to go in a half.
That is
it's amazing.
That's definitely the leading candidate for out of whack stat.
We got an early out of whack leader, folks. If Texas Tech rushes for more yards today than they pass for, you got a scoop.
I can safely say they will not win the game if that holds up.
Trailing at 14-3.
They're averaging over 100 yards rushing this year. When Leach came here, they averaged 66 the first year, 81 the next year, 99 last year, and 109 this year. So they're learning how to run the ball in this system.
After the penalty, second and nine. Fake to Welker. Got a man wide open for a first down. And Torian Henderson out of Gatesville, Texas, picks it up. Well, earlier we asked you now, Tech is averaging better than 44 points a game. When was the last time Oklahoma gave up 40 points in a game? Well, you go back to 1998, and it was Oklahoma State. And it was John Blake's last season as a head coach. It was welcome Bob Stoops after the 41-26 pasting by an arch rival. First down across midfield for Simmons and the Red Raiders. Lots of time here in the second quarter. Good blocking in middle. Complete at the 31-yard line. And it's Mickey Peters. And you know, there are four receivers on this team who can wind up with 1,000 yards this year. And Peters is one of them. He came in with 843, Gary.
Watch Teddy Lehman get over to the wide side when Peters comes across. They're going to run a guy underneath, but Teddy Lehman reads it, lays out for the ball, and just can't quite get there. That's why you have to have a strong arm. To throw against zones, you have to have a strong arm. Man to man, you don't need a strong arm. You can lay the ball in front of the guys.
B.J. Simmons is now 9 yards away from Ty Detmer's record. blows it in with Glover. Ty Detmer came out of Texas and went up to BYU. His daddy was a high school football coach down here. They led Brigham Young to some tremendous seasons. And he set the single season record that B.J. Simmons is going to crash here today. 5,188 yards, and Simmons is closing in. He needs only two more. The next reception should do it. B.J. Simmons headed for the record book. Does it up under center, and instead he'll pitch it out here to Henderson. Henderson struggling for that first down line. Got close, but you see the linesman marked it just short. Perkins making the stop for the Sooners.
I mean, no one believes this game's over, obviously. Remember that Texas Tech came back on the road versus Texas twice. It was 21-6, they came back and took the lead. Then it was 35-21, and they came back and took the lead. So Texas Tech is used to being behind. With this high-powered offense, they know they can drive the ball.
Third down and one. Simmons hands to Henderson for the first down into the red zone. Torian Henderson, 5'9" sophomore. Well, the Capital One halftime show will be coming up. John, Terry, Craig, they'll get a chance to pick their top two for about the 18th time this season. Those Rascals keep changing who we're going to have. It's funny, Oklahoma stays up there with all their picks. First and 10.
Glad they're not charting me.
Back. And Simmons just 2 yards away from the all-time single-season passing record. Sets the screen, and he'll give some back. Henderson thrown for a loss on that play by Allen, number 48, who's been playing impressively here so far today.
Yeah, caught a bad defense that time. I don't know if they have a checkoff ability in Texas Tech's offense, but when you get inside the 20-yard line, Mike Stoops and Oklahoma gets out of that deep zone and starts to blitz you. Very surprised they went to that slow screen to the running back against that defense, because that gets eaten up with those linebackers jumping on the number three receiver, Henderson.
So Ty Detmer just picked up 11. And now B.J. needs 11 to break the record. Got it. There's the record inside the 15-yard line. B.J. Simmons to Nehemiah Glover, the all-time single-season passing yardage record, unless he gives it back.
I'll tell you, the guy can throw the ball. There's no doubt. I mean, I know this is a quarterback-friendly offense. Kingsbury did it, but he puts it on the numbers.
There is Mrs. Simmons. So pleased with the performance of her son here, the brothers watching.
Another B.J. completion.
This would be big if he could drive into a touchdown. Trailing the top-ranked team in the country, 14-3. Third down. Fires complete. That's a first down inside the 9-yard line. Derek Strait defending, but he put it into Glover's hands again.
One of the little hidden qualities that you teach to a quarterback on a slant pass is to throw the ball to the back shoulder. Watch how this ball is thrown. If you see this guy bite, you throw it to the back shoulder. The receiver and the quarterback read it together. That's where this offense gets to be like the wishbone. You run it over and over and over and over again, and you see every possible look.
We get word that USC is up 24-0 on UCLA. Simmons rolls to the right. Fires complete and out of bounds at the 6-yard line. That's Peters. And the singular wireless poll question: what's the best rivalry of the games today? Which one do you like the best? Michigan, Ohio State, Auburn, Alabama, Harvard, Yale, USC, UCLA, California, Stanford. Or you can vote none of the above. I voted for Montana, Montana State. I mean, what the heck they're playing today? And anyway, log on to ESPN.com, search singular, and make your vote, and we'll have an update on that a little bit later. Second and goal. The Red Raiders trying to make a stand here.
Texas Tech was very successful with the draw against Texas.
Yes, they were. Henderson ran it in. This time, they'll throw the screen. Russ Welker from Oklahoma City puts up six on the Sooners, a team he worshipped as a youngster.
In order for this play to work this smoothly, because Oklahoma's so quick, you must be accurate. And watch how accurate this call goes out on the bubble screen to Welker. Hits him right on the front shoulder. It's like a long handoff. Beautiful blocking downfield by Carlos Francis. Puts it into the end zone.
Remember, Tech misfired on a couple of extra points over in Austin. Not this time. Perfect in Lubbock. Welker being congratulated on the sideline. Simmons on the drive. Folks, he was 10 of 10 for 67 yards. He's better into the wind. I'm out.
They're saying just what I've been saying for years. High school ballers just aren't prepared for the NBA. That's funny. They're saying the Dolphins second.